All right, party people. We got our little Canadian visitor down here in Nebraska. Oh boy. Oh my goodness. Let's go to work. Let's get back on the road. It's kind of beautiful. Goodness. My jacket off. I don't like to drive in my big thick jacket. I got a little confession. Just a moment. We'll get ready. Oh, okay. Yesterday, I pulled in here for my 10-hour break, right? And I was getting ready to take my seatbelt off, and I realized I didn't even have it on. I was like, whoa, in 25 years, I've never, it's probably been about at least 20, let me think about that, probably in the early 90s, 92, 91, around there. The last time I got a seatbelt violation ticket. In California, when they implemented that law, I don't know what year it would have been, early 90s. And I am so vigilant about putting on that seatbelt. You don't know how sick I felt when I pulled in here. I go, I unclip it. I go, oh my God, it's not even. Oh my goodness, I didn't even put it on. Oh, I can't believe it. Anyway, so I drove through a weigh station. I rolled over the scale. They got the big window watching you. And I was thinking back over my day, and I was like, oh my God, those guys could have, if they were paying attention, they would have seen. They could have written me up, you know. I mean, that's a seatbelt ticket for a truck driver is, is terrible. Let me do my math, fuel here. I got 75 gallons, and it says I'm running about 6.4 miles per gallon on a lifetime average. I've been in the truck for a little, like a month and 2 days. Of course, that's, you know, 6.4 gallons, and yesterday I did 5.3, which is understandable. I'm climbing. Oops, I meant to. Just a moment, I gotta fix this. Talk to me, baby. No. Oh, reset. Okay, now we can go. Let's go. Oh my goodness. Yeah. I'm trying to talk and you're talking over me. You gotta stop. No, what happened was I pulled in here. This load is about 1900 miles. I'll just round it up to 2000 miles. Oh. You west. Let's say it's 2000 miles. But I don't have enough hours to finish this load in the time they want me to deliver it. Normally I would not accept a load like that, you know, I would turn it, I'm not going to be able to make that load. But this company is kind of different. They'll say, accept every single load we offer you, please, accept it. We'll worry about on-time delivery as far as your hours. In a perfect world, they'd like us to deliver on time, but if they can't, no big deal. They have enough JCT drivers that they can repower the load. So the guy told me yesterday, I'm projecting you're not going to make it, so I'm going to, where are you going to do your 10-hour break? And I said, right here. Is that a rest area or a truck stop or a town or where is it? I go, it's a truck stop, exit 257 in Nebraska on I-80. And that's the last I heard, and they never got back to me. So what am I supposed to do? So I did a 12-hour break waiting for them to, I watched a movie, I watched another movie. I thought, maybe I was going to do a 34-hour break. I don't know. Well, it's midnight, and that's my time to be running. I love to run and start my clock around midnight. I'm not going to sit around till morning. I got to get going. And I slept a cold night last night. It's 21 degrees. I kept the truck turned off. Of course, the APU is still not working. I think it's a fuel problem. Like, it's not getting fuel, so it can't start if it doesn't get fuel, right? So we'll get them in the shop soon. No big deal. I'm not worried about it. I can handle the cold. I've done it before. I got enough blubber on me to stay warm. Comfortable. I like sleeping in the cold. It's easier to sleep in the cold than it is the hot. So what are we going to say? There we go. Try to get some more footage today. I know I had a dry spell, 2 or 3 days where I didn't have anything worthwhile to put up on the YouTube. It was just nothing really to see. I would turn my camera on and look at stuff, but I'm like, I can't post that up. It's not worth it. I mean, it's not entertaining. I got to put quality stuff up, you know? So, but if I see something like this is quality, this is not. I mean, it's icy, windy, snowy. And it's instructional. I can say, hey, you know, I put my, I engaged my interaxial differential lock to drive on this stuff. Temperature's 21 degrees. Everything's ice cold. I'm not worried about ice until it gets like 5, 6 in the morning when it begins to transition from ice to thaw. Anyway, so, all right, so there we go. So we're kind of caught up, and we'll check back in a few.